Welcome back, everybody, to another episode of DuCake's Vivarium, Mob's World, as it is now called in the server list. I have no idea where that Nyan Cat Black came from, but you know what? I'ma take it. So, as I mentioned in the last episode, I'm an idiot and I couldn't count right. So, I found the mistake on this side. It was with the cow. His space was only 5 wide. So, I went and I pushed every section out one further. I put in a few more cages. This isn't finished because I don't have obsidian shards with which to make obsidian glass. So yeah, that's basically where we're at right now. I need to figure out what I want to do with these corners. I need to figure that out. There's so much construction work to do. Like, legit, I need a gajillion blocks of wood. Maybe not quite a gajillion, but I need a lot. And these tiles, I need a ton of as well. Fortunately, I have a near limitless supply available to me, because I have so much cobble from clearing space out that I could build in. So, I've got no worries there. I don't know. I think my whole window system is not working as far as spacing. So that probably needs to be rethought as well. Which is kind of lame because it's a lot of rebuilding that I pretty much am going to have to do. Not looking forward to that at all. But on the upside, I guess. Oh. Fixing everything here didn't really take so horribly long. Now, I suppose I could have done a time lapse again, like I did when I did all the landscaping the last time. But you know what? It really wasn't worth it. I do need to get some floorboards in here. I put a couple extras in because I had some wood on me, but I've used it all up. I actually should see if I've got more back at my base, but for right now, it is what it is. Let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 should be in line there. Yep, it is. Excellent. Just want to get the base going here on this. So I have everything ready to go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Good. I like it when my spacing's right. There's so much building that needs to be done here. Just so much building that it's going to be like episode upon episode upon episode of just building. Like, all of this stone you see on the ground here, it's all got to come out. All has to be replaced with dirt, inside of the cages at least. The walkways where people are going to travel and stuff, I haven't really made up my mind yet what I want to do for that. Like, I could just leave it dirt. But I feel like dirt really isn't the right material to use for the floor in a public area. Like, it rains, now it's all muddy. And obviously, you know, all this real world stuff doesn't apply. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Pardon my counting. Because, you know, we don't get rain in Minetest. And things don't get muddy. Even if it does rain. Because there are a few mods that do add some weather, but still, it's all just fun and games. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, it needs to be one higher. So yeah, I don't know. If you've got any good suggestions, leave them in the comments. Like I was saying last time, because you know people actually do that when you say leave it in the comments. I don't know. Maybe. Maybe every once in a while it happens. Certainly don't know. One thing. I don't understand. Why do I have a shadow here? There's nothing there outside of that protection block. And that protection block is clearly not causing a shadow. And even throwing lights in is not recalculating that very well. I have a feeling, and this may or may not be correct, but I'm betting when that giant sequoia was removed, somehow the light map didn't get updated, and so it still shows its shadow here. I think that's what I'm seeing. Could be wrong. Don't know. Never will know, I'm sure. Alright, well, let's finish up the partitions. This will at least give me a working idea of what everything's gonna be, where it's gonna be, and all that good jazz. Now, one thing I haven't yet really decided on or even given too much thought to, honestly, is just a lot of different design things. Like, I've got this crazy idea, and hear me out, because it's pretty wild. I want to put like a lookout tower right here in the middle. So I've got these pillars. I could build off of those and put a tower up in the center where you can kind of see the whole zoo from in the sky. Trouble is, how would you get up there? Like, what kind of building things do I have here that would work to facilitate anything along those lines? Like, I could do a ladder. And a ladder would work. I mean, it would look kind of silly to have a ladder in a zoo that people are supposed to climb up to see things. But I don't really want to be blocking the floor and making it impassable for people. So, yeah, I guess I don't know for sure. Date not energy bar. Huh. Interesting. Most interesting indeed. Yeah, I might use some baked clay for the ground. If I could, how do you just make the okay, you have to bake a clay block. And that takes 4 clay lumps. I feel like that'd be really expensive, and I probably wouldn't have the resources to do it. But that could be a very nice option. Man, I just love these butterflies! But I don't want to just steal all these flowers. So, I'll just let those sit there for the time being. I had some people commenting on some of my videos about all of my floating protection blocks and how they were ugly. I'm pretty sure that's what they said. Pretty sure they said they were ugly. So, you know what? And I totally agree. They were a mess. The only reason they were there was pretty much just to keep the area from being built in by other people. So I'll at least take the ones out of the walkways. Those, I agree, are kind of silly. Like this guy, he shouldn't be there. That could stay there. It doesn't even matter. It's a wall, but I'll get rid of it. I'll get rid of this one. Man, I need some light in here. This is dark. The only way I know to add light is by using super glow glass, which means I need to get the perimeter going here. Ba-ba-bum. Now how does this work? Ew, what is that thing? Looks disgusting. Anyway. Outside, and there's a tree monster up there too. Outside perimeter gets the protection block. This inside one gets the super glow glass. And then pretty much we just repeat. So this goes over till it gets to this block. Ooh, I'm out. Gasp, I actually am. Fortunately, not to worry. I have 40 more. Boom. Just like that. Okay, so this would be coming into the center. So we will throw some super glow glass there. This is what I did on the other one, right? I wanna... Oh, and on the center too. Oh, wow. Okay. I can't really do that on the center right now, though. Not without throwing in a bunch more blocks. Which, I can probably do without for the time being. It's only light, you know, it's not that big a deal. Throw a protection block there. And I know, somebody in the comments is gonna say, dude, you're wasting so many protection blocks. You don't need to use that many. And you're right, I don't. I can get by with far fewer protection blocks if I use them a little more intelligently, maybe. And if I was a little better at the design and everything, yeah, I could get by with far fewer protection blocks. But that requires thinking, which, as we all know, I am not good at. As is evidenced by the fact that I don't know how to count to six. I'm just going to keep bringing that up. That's going to be like a reoccurring inside joke. And anybody who didn't watch the episode's never going to understand why I keep saying that I can't count to six. And yeah, it'll be hilarious. Oh, those are the wrong pieces. It will be hilarious. What? Oh, that's right. Can't dig with a protection block. But you can with a torch. Physics, kids. Physics. Would that technically be physics? I think it would. And I know I said I wasn't going to put a light there, but eh, whatever. I'm going to do it. Need to grab some more cobble. I still need to figure out so many things. Like why I can't get in that hole. Rah! Okay, so I think I can use any color baked clay and turn it into another color baked clay simply by dyeing it. Which, if that's the case, I've got an okay amount here. Though I was using that cayenne to do the thingamabobs. Yes. The like that little cage thing around the aquarium section. So those I'll probably save to use for that. Because, well, I'm gonna need them. So it makes sense to hold on to them. I only got me four. Cobblestone panel. I don't even know what that is, but I don't think I want one. I thought I was splitting this differently, but I guess not. Okay, that should be enough for right now. I hope it's enough. Depends on how much building I do. Dislike shift jumping together. I need to put one more ladder segment in. That's what I need to do. La 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 la. I'm such an accomplished opera singer. I should be getting paid millions of dollars. Yeah. Probably not. I wouldn't advise quitting your day job, if you know what I mean, man. If you know what I mean. Okay, well. Only like, what, 700,000 more blocks to place before this is in a presentable state where we can proclaim it open to the general public and start charging admission, of course. I need to get more obsidian. Where do I get obsidian? Well, water and a lava source makes obsidian, which makes it particularly difficult to obtain if you ain't got unlimited lava source. Which, yeah, lava does not regenerate. So, obsidian glass is one of those non-renewable resources. Which is why people kill people over it. Okay, yeah, I don't know if that actually happens. But it sounded good in my mind, so that's why I said. Alright, this is pretty lit. This is getting pretty lit up in her. I think I'm going to knock out all of these lights. Yeah, this is lit. I should probably really look that up so I know what that even means before I start using it so much. But it makes for a good joke. It's moody, but it's not too dark. Like, it's not bright by any means. For some reason, there's just like this light. This aurora of light right here. I don't understand why. I don't have anything that's placing lights there, do I? I sure don't think so. Well, I'm gonna put something placing light there. Gonna make this entrance very inviting. I don't know, I wanna do like a big archway. Think like McDonald's, like how they do the big M kind of thing, deal-ish, maybe? I don't really know for sure. But I'm thinking something like that would work pretty well. There we go. First block's always the trickiest because you can't really reach it. So you gotta do some creative jumping around. And it usually works pretty well. Blah, 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 blah. So now is the part of the show where we talk about super interesting things. Like, I don't know. What would you talk about on a show where you're just placing blocks? And it's super boring. Because it's just boring. Nothing exciting's happening. Like, all these poor kids with ADHD and all these other fake made-up diseases. Do they consider ADHD a disease? I don't think they do. But whatever they call it. A disorder. A disorder. Yes. You know, I know a pretty good joke about disorders. It's totally not politically correct. But it's pretty funny. Oh, you want me to tell the joke? I don't know, man. It's not politically correct. I probably shouldn't do that. But it goes a little something like this. Why do they call OCD a disorder? Those people are the neatest ones I know. Think about it for a second. You'll get it. Are you going to think it's funny? No, probably not. You'll probably think, wow, that was really, really rude. Actually, I don't think you will. I don't think those are my viewers. I think the viewers that would think that, all the, I don't know how I want to categorize them without offending anybody. But I think the people that think like that probably aren't the people that watch my videos. They're probably too busy watching cat videos. Which is totally categorizing, but whatever. But yeah. Why would you consider OCD a disorder? Like, people with OCD always want everything to be super neat. What is disorderly about being super neat? Like, I don't get it. I would be inclined to think I have some OCD tendencies. Like, I like things to be neat. But it's weird, because it's almost selective. Like, in this game. Like, right now, this all has to be perfect. I don't know if you've noticed that, but everything follows an exact plan. Like, all these things match perfectly. And that's my OCD. You know, it's got to be done right. If you ain't going to do it right, don't do it at all. You know what I'm saying, son? You know what I'm saying? Just don't do it at all if you ain't going to do it right. But yeah, you know. And then other things. Ah, there we go. Other things are just pigsties, and it doesn't bother me at all. Like, my bedroom's kind of a bit of a mess. No, it doesn't bother me. That was loud. Hello. Oh, are you stopping in for lunch? Here, let me get you some lunch. I don't think he's buying that. No, he's totally passing the sheep up. Yes, stupid alligator crocodile thing. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Calm down there. Calm down. Calm down. There we go. That's the kind of calming down I like to see. Death, carnage, and bloodshed in the game of the year. Because if you want to get game of the year, your game has to be filled with death, carnage, and bloodshed. I don't know why. That's just the way it goes. I don't make the rules, people. I don't even enforce the rules. I don't even follow the rules, come to think of it. Well, I mean, it kind of depends on which rules, I guess, if we want to get technical about it. I mean, like, obviously there's some rules I follow. Like the rule that says gravity. I kind of follow that law. Rule, whichever you want to classify it as. I don't think I really have any option in that one. You know what I mean? Like, I don't think I can just jump off a cliff and say, oh, hey, yeah, by the way, physics, yeah, I don't feel like following those rules today. So, as long as it's cool with you, I'm just gonna jump off this cliff, but I won't actually jump off. I'm just gonna walk off, and I'm just gonna walk in the air, because, you know, why not? Those rules don't apply to me. Rules are made to be broken, after all, weren't they? This is what happens when you give somebody a computer. Or in my case, when you buy a computer, because nobody gave me this. And then you sit in your bedroom for hours on end, talking to a $100 microphone, playing on like a $900 computer, and then putting it on YouTube, putting the resulting nonsense on YouTube for people to watch. And then you make like 20 cents off of the video. At that rate, let's see. Oh, wait, I will never even pay for the electricity I'm using to do this at that rate. Yeah, that's never gonna happen. I need to switch things up. I need to increase my ad revenue. How do we do that? More videos? No, more videos doesn't really do the trick. Because more videos does not guarantee more views. In fact, more videos could actually have a negative impact on the view per video. Because there's more things for people to watch. So they're not gonna, oops, they're not gonna have the time to watch every single video. So it can hurt your performance to put out tons and tons of videos. On the flip side, of course, it can be beneficial because, well, just because. Because I said so, that's why, okay? Just deal with it. Man, I wish I knew what Shadow 36 and. Whoa, who's creatures? Creatures? Interesting, interesting. Not Jonah. I wish I knew how to get Not Jonah out of there. He looks so uncomfortable stuck in my floor. But for the life of me, I don't know how to get the poor guy out of there. Oh, so much building. Can't we just be done? Can't I just like use pixie dust and make it all magically finish? I don't think that works. Hey, here's my reindeer. Hey, good to see you, fella, but you really don't belong up on the second le- No, don't jump! Don't jump! Don't do it! I think I need that suicide awareness hotline number. I need to get in touch with a representative that knows deer language and can help me out because this poor deer, it just, life is just too much, man. You know what I mean? It's too much being a digital creation with seemingly no will of your own, having to bend to the very, what's the word I'm looking for? The very fickle opinion of random people that are playing video games. It's rough, man. It is really rough. It's so not fair either, you know what I mean? Like, hey, why didn't this stupid thing fall? Oh, I see why. Never mind. Like, it's just so not fair, you know? Having to have no choice in your own existence. To be spawned in and out, seemingly at random, by an elithogram. Elithogram? Is that how you announce it? Elithogram? Whatever. However it's enunciated. I don't know. Shoot me. Wait. Sue me. Sue me. That's it. Don't shoot me. That'd be horrible. But yeah. It's so tough, you know? So tough. Somebody needs to... Did that just decay on me? I think it did. Somebody needs to call that suicide awareness hotline and get on the phone with a representative that can help us save this poor reindeer's life. What did I need? Oh, wood. That's right. I need wood. I need a whole lot of wood. This is such a horrible layout. It takes way too long to get into these corners. Wooden slab. Nope. I don't know why I'm even looking. That's my food bucket. Ah! Aha! I'll keep the torch, thank you, but you can take the leaves. Yeah, how about we do that? And you know what? Whoops. Let's go ahead and throw this ladder in there. I can at least get out then. Okay, what do we have that I don't need to be carrying? Tin lumps? Don't need those. Iron lump, coal lump. Yeah, I don't need that stuff. Super glow glass. I'm going to hold on to that. Leather, I don't need that. Don't need that. The dirt. Do I need dirt on me? I don't think so. I'm going to take more wood. Because I feel like I'm going to be needing a lot of that. Sapling? I don't think I need that. I don't even know why I was carrying that with me. I don't need that. Magic lasso? It's handy. In case you bump into something that you want to catch. Alright, that should be... I don't know why I have raw meat in there. Let's throw that raw meat in this furnace and cook her up. Alright. Back to work. Back to putting a roof around this thing. A roof around the riffraff. La 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 la. This is so fun doing this. And I'm sure everybody loves watching me do this as well. Because, well, who wouldn't want to see somebody placing a zillion billion blocks of wood for hours on end, for episode after episode, doing nothing fun like finding lava and obsidian glass and fighting monsters and taming beasts and cool things. No, we'll just watch a dude place a gajillion blocks of wood. Because we have zero better to do with our life. I felt like I heard some deep throaty growls. And I don't know if that was my viewers complaining about the complete lack of quality content I've been producing lately. Or if that was some kind of a monster that was complaining about the poor fare the zoo is giving him and wants to try some new styles, you know? Like maybe a little human flesh. I'm not sure which the case was. Both have me a little worried, though. Like, I need these viewers. Your viewership is super important to me. Because without that, I make no money. And as we all know, and has been established previously in, you know, previous episodes, obviously, the only reason I do this is for money. Like, the day that, I don't even know who, sell around 55, I guess. I don't know who else to say is, like, quote-unquote owner of Minetest. I mean, it's open source, so technically I don't think there's really an owner. But, you know, until the day comes when he's like, yo, man, I want you to do videos for me, man. Like, this is the format I want you to use and just, you know, rock with it, man. You'll do great, man. And I have absolutely no idea why he actually, assuming, of course, Celeron 55 is even a he. I don't even know that, to be quite honest. Like, I don't know, I guess it could just as easily be a girl. I mean, who says that girls can't write code? And the first person that says that, let me tell you, buddy, you're an idiot. Because, yeah, girls can write code. I said it. Girls can write code. Yep, they sure can. I'm not even being sarcastic about that. I'm dead serious. Because I have a few acquaintances. I don't know if I should really call them acquaintances. I should, because I wouldn't say they're friends, because we don't know each other personally. But I know several people that write code for Minetest and are female. And their code is just as good as the code any dude writes. So to all of my, what, 13% of viewers that are girls, don't let any dude tell you that you can't write code, because you can. And to all of the, oh, put that in the wrong spot. To all of the, what would it be, 87% of my viewers that are dudes, don't tell girls that they can't write code, because they can. And you're probably just scared that they're gonna write better code than you write, and you won't know how to react. What are you gonna do? Go cry to your mommy that a girl wrote better code than you did? Like, be a man about it. Admit better code when you see it. That came off as really, really harsh. Like, I just spent I don't know how much time yelling at you guys about code. And I wouldn't even be surprised if a lot of you don't even know how to write code. actually, you know, that's probably not true. I would imagine a lot of you probably do. Because this is Minetest. If it was Minecraft, yes, I wouldn't expect a single viewer to know how to write code. I would expect them all to be like 6-year-old kids who are watching Minecraft videos because they're too poor to afford Minecraft and aren't smart enough to know how to, download a pirate version. That's my assumption. That is my opinion on the general populace of the Minecraft community. They either don't know how to write code and are watching videos because they don't know how to pirate the game or buy the game. I guess there's no reason why you can't legally buy Minecraft. Like, I mean, it's for sale, so obviously you can legally buy it. Unless you don't have the money, in which case, obviously, you couldn't buy it. But yeah. That's my opinion on people that watch Minecraft videos. People that watch Minetest videos, I have no idea why you watch these. Like, my narration, is that what we call this? My voiceover, my talking, yeah, whatever you want to call it, is not like that great. That's like, oh, dude, I gotta hear what this guy's talking about. He's just the best ever. 'Cause don't try to fool yourself. I'm not. I may be the most popular YouTube mind tester, mind test player, whatever. And that's only because of the massive amount of content I have that's related to mind test. But yeah, don't fool yourself into thinking that I am anything special when it comes to knowing anything about mind test. I just know how to write a couple mods, you know, nothing big, nothing major, nothing serious. You know, just some of the most highly anticipated mods and some of the most raved about things. I am so lying right now. Somebody like, you realize that your mods are actually like garbage and that we all hate the work you do and we want you to leave the community because you're a toxic poison. Like, really? Okay, if you say so. Toxic poison that just accused me of being a toxic poison. I totally believe every word you just said. Sarcasm there. I would not believe a word they said. Like, oh. Whatever. Totally off topic. Though there really is no topic in this video, is there? Like, I'm not talking about mind test as a game. I don't even know where to put the protection blocks on these, quite honestly. If this is on that corner, and I put one there. If I have one there, I should. Oh, okay. One should be there, and one should be here. Which would then mean we alternate. No, we keep it the same. Yeah. So this light needs to go bye-bye. Sorry, light. I need a protection block there. And then a light there and a light there. Protection block here. I should have put these lights in before I put those bottom walls in. Would have made traveling so much easier, but what you gonna do? All right, so this is all lit up pretty well. Yeah, this is coming together. Now, if I have a protection block there, do I want to put the protection block here? I think I do, for absolutely no reason in particular. What does that do? That does. Oh, just past the middle. Okay, good. And then this one covers just past. Oh, perfect. And then, where are my next protection blocks? That only covers to that door. And, well, there's not one here yet, but that would do the same. I may bury one underground or something. I like to hide them. Ah, I don't think you can get me. Ha ha! See, that's one of the nice things about. Ah, he's gonna find a way. Yep. Life will find a way. Chaotician, chaotician. Oh, hey, you know what? Oh, hey. You're not supposed to hit me. I don't even know what this thing is. I want it dead, though. What? I get a Nyan cat block from that? So, wait! Excuse me, Mr. Bear, while I build. How long has this been going, anyways? 37 minutes! What am I doing to you? I'm not talking to the bear there, by the way. I'm talking to you, the viewers. That is completely unacceptable. Much too long. I need to wrap this up. Pronto. So let me keep doing stuff for the next 30 minutes. And then I'll be like, well, so you know, guys, it's really been a great 4 hours that we've spent doing this. Yeah, I know, I didn't realize it was 4 hours either. The only reason I even actually stopped this video is because I just really had to go pee really, really bad. And man, I just couldn't hold it any longer. I didn't want to, burst my bladder or something. That would have just been weird. So yeah, sorry guys, but I had to end this 47-hour video because I just couldn't hold my pee in anymore. Okay. I don't know. I thought that was funny. I thought it was hilarious. We're gonna end it here. I'm gonna do some building off camera because this is just. I can't imagine anybody wants to watch this. So here's what I'm thinking I'm gonna get done. To make this video longer, when I said I'm gonna end it, I'm gonna go around and just do this perimeter wall here. I'm not gonna do these interior walls, those can wait. I wanna get this perimeter wall up, and I gotta figure out what I'm doing for windows on it still. But I wanna get that perimeter and this perimeter walkway and all of the railing. So all of that. And yeah, by the time you s this video goes live, if you actually visit the server and visit my Vivarium, this will be like 4 weeks old if you watch or if you go and visit right now. So there'll be tons more done on this. Yeah, so without further ado, thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for listening to my mindless ramblings. If you have any questions, concerns, complaints, or if your parents told you that you can't watch my videos anymore because of my horrible, horrible humor, I apologize, but let me know in the comments. You don't have to watch the video to leave comments, but of course you'd have to know that I said in the video to leave comments that your parents told you you couldn't watch the videos anymore because of my crude comments. Yeah. Anyways, guys, I will catch you next time.